Hi everyone, how are you all? Today we are going to discuss the second chapter of Standard 6 Maths, that is whole numbers. Before going to this chapter, please subscribe our channel Nirja Education. Before discussing what are whole numbers, first we will see what are natural numbers. Have you heard about this word? Natural numbers. Another name of this natural number is that counting numbers. The natural numbers, another name is that counting numbers. Why the name of this natural number is like counting numbers? When we are starting counting, we are starting from 1. 1, 2, 3, like that. So that is why natural numbers are also known as counting numbers. Now you come to know what are natural numbers. Yes, the numbers starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. These are known as natural numbers. So which is the smallest natural number? Yes, 1 is the smallest natural number. Do you know which one is the biggest natural number? We don't know. If I am taking any number, I can add 1 to that number. So we can't tell the greatest number. We will tell it that infinity. We can count and count by adding 1 and 1. We can count the number. So we don't know which one is the biggest natural number, but we know which one is the smallest natural number, that is 1. Now we will see what is a whole number. What are whole numbers? When we are including 0 to the natural numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. These are known as whole numbers. These numbers are known as whole numbers. We are including 0 to the natural numbers. 0 plus natural numbers, it is known as the whole numbers. Now we will see the successor and predecessor of whole numbers. Successor and predecessor. Okay, before going to that one, which one is the smallest whole number? Yes, 0 is the smallest whole number. Already we discussed the natural number, that biggest natural number we can't tell. Like the same way, biggest whole number also, it is very difficult to find. We can't tell the biggest whole number. The smallest one, that is 0. Otherwise, least one, that is 0. Now, successor and predecessor. What are successor and predecessor of a number? We will see that one next. 5671. It's a whole number. I have taken this number. So, you have to find the successor and predecessor of this number. How can you find? Successor means the number comes just after this number. That means you have to add 1 to this number. When you are adding 1 to this number, what will you get? Yes, 5672. That is the successor of this number. Successor means the number comes just after the given number. Now, what is predecessor? Yes, the number comes just before the given number. That means this is the given number, 5671. So you have to subtract 1 from this number. Then what will you get? 5670. So this is the predecessor of this number, that is 5670, and this is the successor of the given number, 5672. Now we will see how can you represent the whole numbers in the given number line, and how can you do the addition and subtraction of these whole numbers using the number line. Now we will see how can we represent the whole numbers on a number line. So this is the number line. So we have to start from 0. Whole numbers start from 0. So suppose you are starting from 0, don't keep this arrow mark here in the left side. This arrow mark represents that this line is continuing. If you are representing this arrow mark this side also, that means here it is continuing. Actually it is not continuing here. 0 is the first number in the whole number. So don't keep arrow mark here. You have to start from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like that. Suppose you are starting from 20 or 21. I am writing, drawing one number line here. I am starting from 21, 22, 23, 24, 25 like that. Here you can keep the arrow mark here because 21 is not the smallest whole number. 0 is the smallest whole number. So you can keep the arrow mark here. So like this way you have to represent the numbers on a number line, whole numbers on a number line. Now we will see how can we do the addition and subtraction using this number line. I am going to take one example, that is 2 plus 4. All of you know that without number line also, that is 2 plus 4, that is equal to 6. How can you find the sum using this number line, that we will see. Here first number is 2. So you have to move 2 points from 0. So 2 points from 0 means here. After that you have to add 4 to this number. That means you have to jump 4 points to the right side, not to the left side. You have to move 4 points to the right side. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, you are reaching here. So 6 is the answer. I will repeat once, 2 plus 4, that means you have to move 2 points from 0 to the right side. So here you have to add 4 to this number. So you have to move 4 points to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, you are getting the answer 6. Now we will see how can we do the subtraction using this number line. Now we will see how can we do the subtraction, multiplication and division using this number line. Already we have discussed addition. How can we do the addition of whole number using the number line. Now we will see the subtraction. In addition, what we have done, we have taken the first number and we have moved forward, that means to the right side. Here the opposite you have to do. We will see that one. 5. So 5 points you have to move to the right. This is the 5, and after that you have to move, subtraction is here, so you have to move 3 points to the left side, not to the right side. You have to move 3 points to the left side. So 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 2. You are getting the answer as 2. Here you have to move 3 points to the left side. Like this way you have to do the subtraction. Now we will see the multiplication. Multiplication, here I have written one example, that is 4 multiplied by 2. So what you have to do is you have to take 4 points, that is here. Like this way 4 points you have to do 2 jumps. I will show you. This is the first jump. 4 units you jump. From 0 you have to do. And again from here to again 4 jumps. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you will reach here 8. So 4 multiplied by 2, that is equal to 8. From 0 you have to start. You have to jump 4 points. 2 times, 2 times jumping should be done because you are multiplying by 2. So 4 points you are taking and 2 jumps you should do. So you will get the answer 8. Now we will see how can we do the division. Here 6 divided by 2. You have to start from 0, 6 up to 6 you have to take, 6 points you have to take. After that you have to jump to the left side. How many unit you have to do the jumping? 2 unit, because the division is by 2. 2 units jumping you have to do. Up to that you will get 0. 6, 2 units means 1, 2. Here again 1, 2. again 1, 2. You got 0. How many times you did the jumping? 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 3. 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. What you have to do? You have to take the first number, that is 6 units you have to take, and you have to check the second number 2. So you have to do the jumping by 2 units. So 1, 2. Up to that you have to do the jumping so that you will get 0. So 1, 2, 3. 3 times jumping we did. So the answer is 3. So like this way you have to use the number line for the operations, that is for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. I hope you have understood the whole numbers and the number lines used for that. In my next video, I am going to discuss about the properties of whole numbers. Thank you.